This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
You write me a note today.
What I do is I'm an advocate for the students. In this job, I have 533 kids, and you see them for 5 minutes.
I go up to the second floor, and I'm like the hall idiot.
You got your form yesterday?
Yes.
You got your form yesterday? Did you bring your book?
I know what it was like to be a student. I know what it's like to be a teacher, and just to try to ease the whole process along.
How many of these do you have?
Three.
Three. Terrific. You get seven, you know what happens?
Kicked out.
Yes. You'll be at Hollywood High.
Okay.
Let me sit down and see what my chair feels like. I enjoy being around kids.
Yeah, they store their books here.
I asked Mr. Furlong to be my prom date.
Really?
He laughed at me.
I didn't drop anything.
They steal my M&Ms. They kind of have the run of the place. They use the phone. Somebody told me yesterday at the faculty meeting I was acting like a fourth grader. And I say, you know, it's harder to grow up when you hang around with 17, 18-year-old kids all day. I lose sense that I'm getting older because nobody around me is getting older. You know, it's kind of a, it's like growing up in Disneyland or something. Every year I come back in September and all the people that I'm going to work with are the same age as they were the year before.
What's up, Fairbanks?
Everything that's said in this group is confidential. Nothing leaves this room. Don't talk about issues that you're dealing with at home or at school or anything concerning you.
I don't know what the hell is wrong with me. Like, sometimes, you know, I go to the mall, you know, these guys, like, check me out, and I don't know, I start to have, I don't get, like, feelings like, oh, my God, she's like, fine. You know, I got, like, a little homophobic, you know? Like, I was looking at, they were smiling at me, and like, I was just like, oh my gosh, you know, I started walking fast and fast, you know. And I got scared, I mean. But I'm like thinking of having like a straight relationship. But I already have like a reputation.
What are you trying to prove to yourself?
I don't know, that's the point. I'm like so confused. I have to know, I can't force myself to be gay.
I'm not sure you could find a girl attractive.
I mean, I've been meaning to try it, but. Everybody, you know, like knows that I'm like the biggest queer in school, you know. It's just like. The problem is like they might be confused. You know, like, well, I, you know, they might be thinking, like, oh, wait, what do you know? You're trying to be straight now, you know?
Does anybody have a burning issue they want to bring up?
Oh, yeah. I have a friend, and I'm really worried about her because she kind of went somewhere with some friends of hers when we were supposed to be at school, and she was kind of out of it, and she ended up having sex with a guy there, and so she's kind of worried that she might be pregnant, and she's, like, she's... It's something that she's not gonna deal with. She says she wants to take her life, so I'm really worried about her.
You said she wants to take her life? Why didn't you tell me? You know, you shouldn't take threats lightly.
Angie knows the person too, so.
Yeah, I know the person.
Oh, you were there?
Very well, because I was the person.
Oh.
But it was consensual. He didn't rape you, right?
Oh, no, no.
Okay. The clinics will plan paired to the free or sliding scale, you know, so if you don't have the money, don't worry about it.
I mean, I can call, like, Teen Line or something and, like, ask them, like, when is it too early to actually get checked? I can call Planned Parenthood or something, you know.
Okay.
LA Free Clinic. Okay, we'll try this one. 1, 2, 3. Oh, When is it too early to actually have like a pregnancy test?
It's all the exam a week from tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Your choices are Monday through Friday. Which one?
Oh, next week?
Yeah.
Like next Thursday. I don't feel like exactly 2 weeks.
We can go like after school if you want.
After school. If you could.
I can go.
Hey, teacher.
The kids are foster kids, and she's paid to take care of them. I feel like maybe if, you know, she was paid to take care of me, I'd matter more. I don't know.
All right, Shelby, please. I said get off of it.
Maria, leave her alone.
Mom, please.
Let her do it.
She's making too much noise.
For who?
For me.
Who cares?
Sometimes I just feel like my mom abandons me. Like, not, like, literally abandons me. Like, just sort of makes me feel that way, you know?
Happy 21st birthday, boy. At least they know who I am. 21st, yeah.
That's from Jean and me. Mom, you're bending that bag. That bag was like a good penny.
Pammy gives me a bag. She makes it from scratch.
Nothing I do is ever good enough for her recognition.
She's really trying to tell me I stink. So I better get something on my those big balls.
We never find that medium. We never find that in between. We're always like one extreme or the next. It's like we really get along or we don't deal with each other.
Remember when we were talking about like running away or whatever? You said that if they call the police and you're in school, they can't do anything?
I'm curious why you asked that. But if you're thinking of running away, I'll tell you one thing. Once you run, it becomes, in your mind, a way of dealing with problems is to just run away. And the bottom line is, it doesn't change the fact that the problem's still there.
I want to leave my house. I don't give a fuck where I go. As long as it's not on the street, I just want to leave.
Because once you've tested this, oh, there's no stub. Stop it now. Excuse me. Stop right now.
I can't ask you for things that I need for you to sit there and tell me no, like a poster board. I'm sorry, that's what hurt me. That's what hurt me more than anything. I asked you for a poster board for a project, and you said you couldn't afford it.
You told me you suck. What kind of stuff is that to tell your mother?
I told you I...
You sounded like Shelby. She does that kind of stuff.
I told you I don't... I can't say anything nicer. That's the problem I'm faced with. I'm trying to salvage a relationship for in the future. So I can come home to my mother and look at her with respect.
And sometimes I don't think you even see that I do anything.
No, I do see it.
I haven't got time to get out of the car and come in the house and take a shit. Half of the time. I feel like I'm glued to the car seat because it's from work to home to pick her up, to pick you up, to take you to work, to do this, to that, then go get her, and then it's never ending.
This is what I think. To save your life. No matter what struggles you might have to go through, I don't think you should have to raise anybody. I just don't
think. Think of a better place for them?
Honestly. Mom.
I mean, I know I'm not the greatest, most perfect person, but can you think of a better place for them?
In a group home would be fine.
Nah, I don't even think so.
Be their grandmother.
And what do I do when you leave? Just sit there and twiddle my thumbs. I don't want to be by myself.
I'm gonna prove to myself that I can be independent, and you're just gonna have to understand. I mean, I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm trying to
be
me.
But that's because you throw two different things at me. You throw, leave me alone. I'm old enough. I can do what I want. Wait a minute. Then when I back off, you bitch at me because I don't pay enough attention to you.
Mom.
And that's what's got me in a spin because I don't know which way I'm going.
I'm a teenager. You have to be in a spin. You've had 7 teenagers before me.
So what?
You have to understand what teenagers are.
I haven't had a teenager like you, ever.
I need to just get away. If it's staying at a friend's house a couple of days, just seeing how things go, that's what I need to do.
I have problems like anybody else, but you know what? I'll survive them and be the good father that I want to be. I want to be the best father ever.
He woke my mother up with a kitchen knife in each hand and stabbed himself for her to see. Every chance he gets, he lets us know that we're the reason for what he did to himself.
What's he talking about? What's going on with Jean?
Oh, I called my dad. He said, what's up? I just forgot everything I told him. I missed him, and I wanted to see him. He said to stop lying to myself and just face it, not to think that he was ever gonna be there for me or my sisters again. That he didn't respect me as a person anymore, he said. And that the only thing he remembers from those 17 years he was with me is pain. And everybody was looking at me and just waiting for me to say something to them after I got off the phone. But I didn't want to talk about it. And I went into the room and I tried to go to sleep. Rio followed me in there. I just started crying. I couldn't stop.
Knowing you, and I'm sure everyone in this room could say that, he is a fool. Because you are a wonderful person. He is cutting himself off from everything that you are and are going to become.
I just want to be there like I was before with him. Have that same type of bond, that same type of feeling. It's not there, but I want that. I love him, I miss him.
Yeah, it's just big.
So what's going on, man?
Man, nothing much. Just out here, doing something I always wanted to do, but never had enough time to. You know, learning and shit.
So is this the first time you've ever done a piece with John?
This is the first time I've ever done a piece. I love art and I might as well, you know, drop something before I leave. Nah, I already know this shit is gonna be dope when I'm done.
And you are?
Melanie.
And you are?
What?
You're Judy's girlfriend, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. I'm just a girl.
Oh, okay. That's cool. I got it.
Hey, how long have you and your girl been getting together?
Like, 3 months, something like that. I knew her from way back, from like in seventh grade. And like, we lost touch. I met her again in February and shit. We was at a function. We different, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, we the same people. That's like, I don't know.
Would you say you're in love, man?
Come on, man. Yeah. Yes, I am.
The first time, man?
This is the first time, truly. It's like it's a lot of new things. Like, this is like so much bigger, you know what I'm saying? Everything is so much bigger than what I thought it was, you know?
So, Jim, where are we going?
We're gonna go check out my prom dress.
Have you already picked it out?
Yes.
How much is it?
I have no idea. That's what we're gonna find out. It's $200.
I think you guys should like find a prom date that's good looking with a car who has money and like surprise me with like prom tickets.
Pointing issues right now. Prom. The guy who's gonna design my dress, Jomo Patterson, he came to my house last night and we sat down and went through all the drawings and everything and then we combined something for my dress.
Did you go to a prom?
No, they didn't want me to go. Oh, they didn't think it would be nice to be out late.
Really?
Yeah, so I'm gonna make sure she does all of it.
Now I just need like a really fresh date. I still don't really have a date.
Oh, you need to stop.
What? No. No, he doesn't. We're like this. We're like tight.
God. She's wearing a black prom dress. Like she's going to a funeral.
Misha, you going to prom?
I might.
Hold the gun to your head and say you better go.
I gotta find me a girl that's gonna drive me to a prom.
I was the VP in the 11th grade. And now I'm nothing. I'm not a cheerleader. I'm not in leadership anymore.
And I don't have office in BSU. So I'm not really anything, just a regular student. And that sucks a lot.
Really?
Yes, a regular student with no prom date.
Before I go on to them, I'd like to know, what's happening? Are you still out?
No. I went home on Wednesday.
All right.
You know, and my mom and I talked.
So what made you decide to make the dress?
She begged me.
Okay. I need a prom dress really bad. That's really petty.
She came by and said she loved me. And would I do her dress? I said, well, if you're going to be here, try it out. Yeah, I'm coming. Okay.
I was shopping around for Texas. It was the last minute. I didn't really want to call up my dad. Mom kind of convinced me. She said, well, he's your dad, just ask him for an opinion. And I knew he had a friend that has a tuck shop.
Your dad knows this guy?
Yeah, I used to work for him. Wow. Like long, long time ago. And he was a teenager.
I'm a master tailor. I can do anything. I can do a suit, I can do a pant.
He opened up his own shop when he was 18 in downtown. He had two shops.
What's up? And all of a sudden, I lost my job. They were paying me like $12 an hour now. And there was somebody there in my place, and they were paying him the minimum wage. The last time that I worked as a tailor, that was in 1990. I grew up with this environment.
I remember.
I have all this, I have my machines. This is the way I used to be in the back working when I was a teenager.
Did I not show you the purse I made her?
You saw?
Yeah. Well, you taught me.
Yeah.
I still remember. Not so much. At first, I wasn't sure exactly what I was doing, but when I terminé, everything was quick.
Yeah.
Hey,
Sergio,
I'll call you.
Yeah.
He doesn't call me. He expects me to call him, and for a long time, I didn't. I had, like, this anger towards him. Well, he messed up, and why am I going to be the one chasing after him? It's always my steps first, and I just wanted that to change, and he's just not that way. It's not going to be like that.
It's like this. Females is a trip, man. It's like y'all the most beautiful thing ever created, man. But it's like y'all illin', dude, 24/7, around the clock. Yeah, I just got off the phone with my lady and things, you know. And jealousy and insecurity got the best of her, you know what I'm saying? Hold on. Hello. It's just talking about you. But it's just talking about you. I love my girlfriend, you know what I'm saying? I would never cheat on my girlfriend, straight up, you know what I'm saying? People need to trust people. It's the devil fucking with your brain.
This girl called me, you know what I'm saying? This girl, who was my friend, who doesn't even like dudes, called me and was like, my parents are kind of forcing me to go to prom, you know what I'm saying? And I have a girlfriend, you know what I'm saying? It's like, they don't want me to go with no girl.
Do you
want
to talk to her?
I'm gonna call her right now. Yo, her girlfriend's over there right now, too. You can talk to her, too. Now, this is gonna be some shit.
I have a girlfriend, and my parents and my family won't be able to come. So that's why he was gonna go. I mean, it's cool. It's just like, I don't know. Like, I mean, it's not gonna be like all nighters. It's just a few hours or whatever. My girlfriend said he can kick it with her. And so, yeah, I mean, he'll be home. I mean,
hey,
man, like, I'm trying to get with him.
Emma? Where'd she go? Ah, oh, shit.
Why is this such a big deal?
I don't know. Ask her that.
No.
You see, the thing was, I had asked Melanie if she wanted to go to prom with me. And Melanie said no.
Appreciate you putting me in the middle of the street. Like, did you hear me?
Yeah. All right, well, you know, hold on. I know. Hold on. Hey. Hold on.
She does have a serious problem because,
you
know what, you have a serious problem right now too, which I don't
want to
speak to.
I already know. It's about keeping it real, you know? See, niggas pay a lot of penalties for keeping it real, man. Tell me. What's up, dog? Hey, man, I need you to do me a favor, man. Hey, who you going to prom with, dog? You know
she needs you to go to prom with her. That's taken care of. I'm not going with her. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. I'm sorry.
Based on the fact that I know that she loves me, based on the fact that I know I love her, I know that everything is gonna be all right.
Maria, Maria. Hey, I'm doing it by hand and it's hard. Like, look how long it is, oh my God. Or maybe we'll make some real full, this here stuff right underneath the skirt about this long, you know, so it puffs up that part.
Beautiful dress, Mom. I love you. Thank you.
But if ain't done soon, you're gonna kill me?
No. If you don't finish it today, I'll live. It's okay.
Like this.
Don't quote me on that or anything.
Because you may hate me, I know. I got the message.
So where are we going, man?
Oh, where I used to live. I want to go show my dad my tux before I go to prom.
What? So what do you think? Like it or not?
Like it. I like it.
I'm proud. Hey, what you're doing is nice, man. And anything you want me, I'll be there for you. Honestly. Okay.
Well, I mean,
yeah.
Dad gave me 16 good years. Great years. Taught me a lot. I mean, there's a lot of stuff he could have done better, but that's with all parents. I'm not going to be the best parent. I'm just going to try to be better than him, like he was trying to be better than his father. Hopefully in the future that we'll all have perfect dads.
I'm so excited, I can't believe prom is tonight.
Hey, why you gotta get a comb in my hair?
Limited to be and live. class of 2000. I need to sport this. When I roll up in the palace, I'm gonna sport this. I'm gonna be like, you know what? Yes. Yes. I'm gonna be like, yes.
There's much more of senior year at PBS Online. Hear all the music, talk about this episode, and follow the stories you'll only find online at pbs.org. To order the entire senior year series on video cassette or the companion CD to the series featuring Oso Motley, Ani DeFranco, The Coup, and others, call PBS Home Video at 1-800-PLAY-PBS.
This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Why do you think I might not think it's appropriate for you to be standing in the back doing this?
You're trying to catch a picture of me. I'm gonna be me. If you're gonna take my picture, I'm gonna be me in that picture.
No, hey.